Our objective is to get those first one or two development deals out into the public. And we're confident that that's going to happen a little bit quicker now in this early part of the year.
All right, welcome back inside our Proactive Newsroom. And joining me now is Don Currie. He is the CEO of Hillcrest Energy Technologies. And Don, it's great to have you back again. How are you?
I'm doing very, very well. And thanks again for having us back.
Yeah, well, you've got exciting news out. You sort of updated everyone on where the company's at and really what the next stages are as you head towards commercialization for the zero voltage switching technology that you have. And let's begin with the company itself, because I know you've made some changes as far as where people are going to be in their roles, and also added a business development person.
Yeah, look, it's all encompassing. So I'll start with Nad Karim. Nad Karim is a Silicon Valley veteran, I should be able to say, who can open up a lot of doors for us. He's very well ingrained, 25 years experience at Silicon Valley. As we're moving, we've always said that we're agnostic to the use of our technology, whether it's in traction, so EV or stationary, like the grid. And he has the ability to do a lot for us and open up some doors and create some meetings with the stationary uses. You know, think about it. The holy grail for us would be a data center. Think of the Amazons, the Googles, that sort of thing. A data center using our technology for efficiency would be unbelievable. And we see Nad as the type of person that can open those doors. We've been talking to him for a while. We've got to a point now that we can announce him, and some early stage discussions or introductions have already started. What that does is now you lead into some changes within the company. Ari Berger, our CTO, when we started this, traction, we were going after EV, and Ari is second to none in motor controls. So any sort of motor, electric motor, there's no one better than him at working on this. But we need to be able to focus here in this particular center on more grid-related applications, because the EV side, as we said, is going over into Germany as a center of excellence there. That's where that work's being done. Come right back to the beginning, and hopefully this makes sense. The ZVS technology, the zero voltage switching technology that we're applying across the board, is essentially complete. Any work now will be project specific. So that means that Ari's work with the ZVS, zero voltage switching, is essentially complete. He's still involved. It just means we're kind of changing the chairs around a little bit and titles that indicate better what people are doing.
Yeah. You mentioned the centers of excellence, and that's one thing that was in the news release. You talked about distinctly separating Vancouver and Germany for what they do. Talk to me a bit about the decisioning behind that and what it means.
Yeah. Any sort of work that we've done on the traction or the EV side has really been focused in Europe. That's where our connections have been. That's where we've been able to open up doors. And Systematic, our partner, they've been a power electronic design house that's been working with the German automotive industry for 20 years. So it just makes sense to have the people that we need focused over there. So again, the ZBS technology is done. There's different things that we're doing to fine tune it. And so the people that will be fine tuning it and working with that will work directly in Germany. They'll be based in Germany in that facility, overseen by the company here. And we still own 100% of the IP. We still are the business development people, so on and so forth. But the EV side will be there. We see North America and Europe as well, but we see North America as having huge upside for us on the technical side, or on the grid side. And that's where we're increasing the technical abilities here. So while they are EV, we'll be the grid side. We still work together on various things. And so we'll be bringing in more people here that have a decade's worth of experience on the grid related side.
So when you talk about advancing towards commercialization, Don, what does that look like? What can people expect in 2025?
You know, we've been saying in 2024, we expected to come out of 2024 with some development agreements or agreements in place with various companies. And we worked right through Christmas. We're very, very close. So I'll say it at this point in time, that our objective is to get those first one or two development deals out into the public. And we're confident that that's going to happen a little bit quicker now in this early part of the year. New budgets are in place. It seems like the culture of the companies that we're dealing with are opening up a little bit. But more importantly, the grid-related companies, the ones that are in the stationary applications, they move much quicker than EV does. They're not as prone to having to worry about sales cycles or the industry at large. They need to keep up and move forward. So again, that's what we're telling the people we're talking to, is that we need to move forward as quick as possible. The first, second, third one that comes in, that's the one we're moving forward with. And I think that we can expect to see some commercial development deals brought to the public in the very near future.
Okay. And lastly, it just seems like this announcement and the things that you've accomplished between Vancouver and Germany and the changing of the chairs, as you mentioned, of what people are doing, really streamlines the company and sets it now up for what you have described there as the growth that you're going to see in 2025.
That's exactly way of putting it, a very good way of putting it. You know, from the Europeans' perspective, when they're dealing with systematic, they're essentially dealing with us. They can move forward and they have authority to move forward on certain applications or discussions that don't require our involvement until the end. And here we're moving forward on the grid related side. And you have, well, Nad is our business development person and very, very, very well connected in North America. He has substantial experience over in Europe as well. So we're lining it up so that there's a streamline, there's a path to discussion, there's a path to decision. And I think we're very, very close to having completed that.
All right, exciting times ahead. Don, thanks so much. Great to catch up with you. And sounds like we may be talking very soon in the future.
We hope so. And thanks once again for having us.
All right, there's Don Currie, the CEO of Hillcrest Energy Technologies.